Just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Both teams are on the field, and we're just about ready to open things up. Deep to return. It's fielded at the two. And he's taken down at the 29. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. They come out on an empty backfield. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 29. Makes the grab and steps out right away.
I credit the quarterback on that pass. He made a great read and delivered a very nice pass for the first down.
They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. First tight end over the middle. And down he goes at the 40. A good play fake that time.
Here, the play action was key. They held the linebackers there by the fake by the running back. And the running back did a very nice job of carrying out his fake.
Brought down at about the 39-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
Pass out to the tight end, but it's incomplete.
Number 87 was the intended receiver.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 30.
Brings up third and 10.
And he's level at the 48-yard line. Perfect time to bring the freshman corner on a blitz.
It's crazy to think that he was only in high school less than a year ago.
Right now, he wants to get this kick away and change field position. And this one is a beauty. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Cougars' offense basically predicated on what this kid can do.
The thing I love about this guy, Brad, is just the intangibles that he brings to the table. We've been seeing this guy make plays over the weeks, but the thing that I really recognize is his ability to really lead this football team. When things are going well, he's patting everybody on the back. When things are not going well, he's trying to pick them back up and getting them ready to go. So not only does he physically have the tools, but also I really love the way he approaches the game.
They'll bring him down at about the 27-yard line.
6 yards. That makes it third and three.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. And he's tackled at the 35-yard line.
Wide receiver's role in a play-action pass is to get into position and to hit his spot in timing and rhythm with the quarterback. And that's exactly what they were able to do on this last play. You realize you've got a little bit more time because of the play action, and it gives you more time to get to that point that the quarterback's looking for you to be at. But make sure you do a good job of selling your route and getting in position to give an open target for the quarterback.
Good tackle there in space. So they go on the ground and pick up another first down.
They are stringing together a nice little drive here. If they keep this up, it'll be hard to keep them out of the end zone.
And he throws it away. From the 36-yard line, it's second down. They try to get a head start there.
False start, offense.
That penalty will move them back a bit.
Yeah, with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
Right, Roger. Go down, go down. Back 41.
under pressure. Missed tackle. Incomplete. Almost picked off. Nice job getting a hand on that one.
Yeah, really good heads-up play there to get a hand on the football by the defense.
From the 41-yard line, third down. He throws left. Makes the grab, and he's knocked out of bounds. Big play right there.
That makes it first and goal.
He's tackled at the six. Williams comes away with about 2 yards and a little draw play. He'll get it again. Touchdown, BYU!
Oh, that's a great job and some tough running right there. When you get close to the end zone, things get very tight and it's tough to maneuver.
And he adds the extra point. A 10-play, 85-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
He's to the 20. He got hit hard. The Cougars are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. He's taken down to the 37-yard line. Tackle around the 46-yard line. Field. He makes his way to about the 32. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
From the 32-yard line, first down. Give to the running back, and he's going to lose yardage.
Loss of 2 on the play. That'll bring up 2nd and 12.
The Utes saw one of their top players going down earlier, but it looks like he's going to be able to get back in there. They try to run up the middle, but met in the backfield.
No gain. That brings up 3rd and 12.
He lets it go. This one will fall incomplete.
Quick thinking there. You know, they're liable to put the ball in the air on third, so it's a smart play to keep your hands ready.
They'll call on the field goal unit. It's up. And they come away empty-handed. So our count is still 7-0 BYU.
I was really impressed with their last series. They came out with a focus on the passing game, and the offense got the job done. We'll see if they have the same strategy here.
Nice run there.
Call it a gain of 5 yards. That brings up 2nd and 5.
Brigham Young is up a score. Tackle after decent pickup.
Good for a gain of 6 yards.
Back to him, and he gets nothing this time around.
That's a loss of 3 yards. That'll bring up 2nd and 12.
Second down at 12. Ball on their own 42. Decides to slide.
Slides on the play. Gain of 2 yards. Third down.
Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts.
Kurtz, the intended receiver on the play. That brings up 4th and 11.
McCormick, the return man. He fields the punt at the 16. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line.
The Cougars really came prepared to play defense today, and the plan is working.
Well, so far in this game, you've got to tip your cap to the defensive coordinator. He has clearly done a very good job of getting his team ready to play, and they have done a nice job of slowing down this very explosive offense.
The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, 5 wide receivers in the formation. Nice run there as they work the outside. And they make the stop at the 48.
That makes it 1st and 10.
Now he tries to buy some time. He's at the 40. Dives forward.
Well, this is a nice run for the first down by this quarterback.
Steps out of bounds, right around the 30.
That'll make a 2nd and 7.
Fires it out, and he's taken down around the 22-yard line. The middle for a nice game.
That's a game of 7 in the play. That makes it 2nd.
It's 2nd down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. This game's already shaping up to be a good one as we head to the second quarter. 7-0, Cougars. And we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter. Touchdown, Utes. Great call by the offensive coordinator.
Big time play, taking that ball all the way in. Maybe the defense wasn't expecting a run.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he tacks on the extra point. So a 7-play, 71-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 21. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Tackle made at the 19.
That's a loss of 2 yards. That'll bring up 2nd and 12.
It's 2nd and 12. Ball on the 19-yard line. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And down he goes, around the 26-yard line.
Williams brings him down at the 26-yard line. That'll bring up 3rd and 6.
set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. Look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time. It's away, and it's a booming punt. And down he goes at the 44-yard line. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Got some open field. Gains his way to the 43-yard line. Gets it out quickly. He gets hit out of bounds at the 32.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they looked sharp before this one even started.
There's a strike complete, and he is drilled at the 23. Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Quick throw out to the receiver. Big play, and it's first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
Tackled after a decent run up the gut.
Gain of four on the play. That brings up second and goal.
We've got second and goal. 2 yards to the end zone. The Utes wideout out with an apparent injury, although he might make a comeback before this game's over. Touchdown, Utah! Nice run and a score by the halfback.
And a nice call by the coach there. Just give it to your main man anytime you're near the goal line.
He makes the PAT. It was a 7-play, 56-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He gets to about the 34-yard line.
Gain of 9 yards. That brings up second and one.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
Gain of 7 yards. First down.
And he carries the ball for a nice game.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards.
Roger, Roger.
That brings up second and five.
41's coming. 41's a Mike.
Easy. Easy.
They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
Called a loss of 4 yards on the play. That brings up third and 10.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 49. Big hit. He's going to lose yardage.
Called on the tackle at the 34. That makes it fourth and 12.
The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. Oh, excellent punt. He's out to the 30. And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Utah is up by a touchdown. He scrambled, got the corner. Brought down around the 38-yard line. To the back. Nice run to the outside. And they're not going to get it. Great stop. The halfback loses about one on the option. Brigham Young will take their first time out of the half. Hackett awaits the snap. And this one is a beauty. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Quick pass. He's brought down in the open field.
That'll bring up second and three.
Incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver.
I love to see a confident quarterback, but you don't want to just go back there and put blind faith into your throws. You need a little bit more time to evaluate the coverage before you release the football.
Here's the halfback on the screen. He's to the 40. They'll bring him down at about the 47-yard line.
That's good for being 20 yards. That makes it first and 10.
He's going to try and scramble. He gets sacked on the play. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
So that sack sets them back a little bit now. They're looking at second and 13. Throws it to the halfback, and he's got it again. Tackled for a loss. But come up just shy of the first.
Good play call, almost perfect execution, except for the fact that they're not going to get the first down.
They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Utah is up 7. To the right and tackled immediately. So we've played two quarters. Utah in front, 14-7.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. This game's been everything we anticipated it being, each team matching each other blow for blow. Just a one-possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two games match up the hype. And we talk about it all week and how big this game is, and it's going to come down to players making plays. And, you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground, and which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right and you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation that can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way. Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here.
Excellent kick.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Utah's coaching staff will go out tonight. I think the offensive coordinator should buy the defensive coordinator his meal.
Well, the defense has been great. There's no doubt about it. But I just think that the offense that they're facing, they've just been so conservative, so predictable. It's made it very easy for this defense to have a dominant game.
Quick throw to the back. It's incomplete. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. And he's stopped behind the line. This one will fall incomplete. They're going to be forced to punt it away here.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
McCormick will be the return man. He really got a hold of that one. He gets out to about the 45-yard line. He did a good job there to give his team decent field position. They're set to go for another round. Utah is up a score. Throws complete. He's got space to work. Tackle at the 27. Tackled at the 14-yard line. He goes out of bounds at the 11.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
Tackled after a decent pickup.
That's good for 5 yards. That'll bring up 3rd and 2.
He's taken down at about the 3-yard line. Touchdown, Utes.
I think the option down by the goal line is a great call. It puts so much pressure on the defense and allows the quarterback to have the decision to run it or pitch it. And this time it worked to perfection.
And he
converts the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The defense really stepped up to force that three and out on the last drive.
Down two possessions, this offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That brings up second and five.
Nice run up the middle.
That's a game of seven on the play. That makes it first and ten.
Nice run, and he's brought down.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
Diving for extra yardage.
No gain. Third down.
Easy.
And they make the stop right around the 44-yard line. Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Gets to about the 24-yard line. The Utes aren't easing back, that's for sure. They're not content to sit on the lead they had.
No, I think they're continuing to go out and execute, try to extend this lead, and just playing overall much better here in the second half.
And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 24-yard line.
Here we go.
Gets out to around the 32.
That'll bring up 32.
And he tackles him hard at the 37. Throw. And he's taken down at the 50-yard line. Tackle made right around the 36-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Fires quick to an open man, he dropped it. From the 36-yard line, it's second down. They come out in a five wide set. Complete pass and hit hard as he came down with it. To him again, complete. So close, but they fall short of the first down.
You got to throw the ball a little deeper next time. Don't take any chances of coming up short.
So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. Somebody jumped early down there.
False start, offense.
Just a mental lapse, but it's going to cost him 5 yards.
Still fourth down.
Kick is up, it's got the distance, and he splits the uprights. Phillips is lined up to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Gain of 5 on the play. That brings up 2nd and 5.
He's to the 40, and down he goes at the 41.
That's good for a game of 11 yards. First down.
Down. Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
That's a game of 5 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
Pitches back. Nice run to the left there.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. First down.
Up the middle for a nice gain.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
He gets out to about the 42-yard line.
That's a gain of 1 on the play. That makes it third.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Gain of 4 yards. That makes it 1st and 10.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. They'll knock him down for a loss.
That'll bring up 2nd and 12.
2nd and 12 coming up here. Ball on the 40. The Utes defensive back left the game with that injury earlier, and the sooner he gets back, the better, because they've been really working over his backup. The cavalry's coming.
You know, at that point, I think, Brad, the quarterback's just better off just taking a sack. You have to be very careful as you're feeling pressure to throw the ball just to throw the ball. If you feel like you're not going to be able to make the play and the defense got you, just give up on that play and get ready for the next down.
Throws it deep.
What a huge letdown by the defense on a big third down play. Man, that is just inexcusable.
Hits him hard at the 1.
Gain of 3 yards. That brings up 2nd and goal.
One more quarter to play. Utah's lead is 17. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. Down around the 3-yard line.
That's a loss of 3 yards. That makes it 3rd and goal.
Here we go, 3rd and goal from the 3-yard line. And they'll get him in the backfield.
Good job by the defense to overpower the offensive line and drop the back for a loss.
That brings up 4th and goal.
Caught with room to work. They'll bring him down at the 3.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. They come out in a goal line set. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Pulls it in and he's in the open field. That's a great tackle at the 16. Out of bounds around the 19-yard line.
That's a gain of three on the play. That makes it second and six.
Fires out to his wideout, and he's tackled around the 26-yard line.
That'll bring up third and inches.
He fights forward to about the 29. It's second and 10. Ball on the 29-yard line. Quick pass. Tackle around the 39-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Brought down. A nice run up the middle. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers. Got a man. Watch out here. He's tackled at the 48-yard line. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds. Gets it out quickly. He's taken down around the 31-yard line. He's going to try and scramble, and he can't get away from the pressure.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
13th play of the drive coming up. Short over the middle. Missed tackle.
Williams with the reception. Losses around the play. Fourth down.
It's fourth down. They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. Kick is up, and he nails the long field goal. Everyone's all lined kickoff. He just drills this one. They'll bring him down at the 24. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Complete. He's got room. And he is drilled at the 31.
7 yards.
Man left, man left.
That'll bring up second and three.
41's coming. 41's the mic. Easy. Shit.
He's in trouble. And they make the stop at about the 31. Throws to the receiver, incomplete.
Boy, a golden opportunity missed by the defense. That was a sure interception, only to be dropped.
Big stop defensively.
Yeah, they only needed a few yards here to keep the drive alive. Great job by the defense to shut them down.
They picked up 3 points on their last possession, and they've got great field position to work from here. Gets to about the 27-yard line. It's second down, 7 to go. Ball on the 27. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. A loss on that one as he couldn't get past those big linemen.
You got that right. They sacrificed their bodies in there and stuffed him.
Under a minute left in the game. Inside the 10. Touchdown, Utes. Well, there's a touchdown that we really don't care about. This game is still well out of reach. And he tacks on the extra point. So a short three-play, 30-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. So our score, 34-7. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. We're late in the fourth quarter. This game has been a blowout for quite some time, and Kirk and I are just looking to make our flights. He's level at the 27-yard line. The Cougars taking their first time out of the half. Second and 8 coming up here. Ball on the 27-yard line. He throws it. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. A nice looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
Goes out of bounds at the 44-yard line.
Gain of 8 yards. That'll bring up second and 3.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
41's coming,
gets to about the 34-yard line. Brigham Young will have one timeout remaining.
When you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
From the 34-yard line, second down. Just throws this one away. For Kirk and Aaron, I think I can say we're glad this one's over. 34-7, Utes. So, Kirk, how would you sum up the action in this one?
Well, this rivalry game didn't live up to the hype this year. There's pure gratification on one sideline and sheer disappointment on the other. You can bet that the loser in this one will have this date marked in red on their calendar for next year.
Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.